Phillip Island circuit for the long-established Australian round of the MotoGP World Championship. The weather is great and the temperature is perfect for racing, so we're just waiting to find out which riders have opted for hard tyres and which riders have opted for soft. Engines are fired. The riders are ready. Just a few moments to go and another Australian Grand Prix will begin here at Phillip Island.
Incredible World Championship here at Phillip Island. Cal Crutchlow very well. The grid. Will Crutchlow get the run down to the line? Paul Espargaro, though, will get the whole shot. What a start from third place by the Monster MR Tech 3. Man, it's Paul Espargaro from Marc Marquez. Crutchlow's back in fourth place with the latest Espargaro now up in a third. Into the southern loop they come, so Paul Espargaro leads the way. Marquez closes up on him. Crutchlow in a big, big battle there for the latest Espargaro. Crutchlow into the southern loop, up towards the stolen corner. And Marquez very, very close. And Marquez perhaps fancies his chances at the hairpin on the very first lap.
Brilliant start by Danilo Petrucci on the Pramac Ducati. He's already picked up three spots into third. Jack Miller was looking up the inside of a couple of riders going into the hairpin. Marquez leads though at turn four.
Yeah, at the hairpin. You can see he was closing up and thinking about it. There is Danilo Petrucci. Alessio Spargaro. Then get a good view of Jack Miller behind his great mate, Cal Crutchlow. But Marquez leads the way. This is just not what the men that made bad qualified wanted to happen.
Oh, Lorenzo's already up into ninth place. Ross has picked up a couple of spots in the 13th. There was obviously a technical bump for Loris Bowes. He started the race from the pit lane. Down the hill into turn 10 for the first time. Marquez, Paul Espargaro, Alex Espargaro has a look up the inside of Danilo Petrucci. He runs the Italian a little bit wide, but Alex Espargaro holds firm and takes third place. Crutchlow also sweeps on Petrucci. He got picked up there, Petrucci coming through turn 10 and lost two places.
Two Espargaro brothers, the younger one in second place, the older one in third place, but for how long? Crutchlow now on the rear wheel of Suzuki as they come down towards the Doohan corner, first time round. Here is Alex Espargaro. Here comes Crutchlow on the brakes. Danilo Petrucci determined to get back on Alex Espargaro, not able to do so. But Crutchlow moves up into third.
Vincioso using the grunt and the slipstream of that Ducati to move by Jack Miller on the run down to the Doohan corner. So Vincioso up inside the top six. He holds firm on Miller through the southern loop. Marquez leads then from Paul Espargaro. Paul Espargaro led Premier Class Grand Prix for the first time in his career on the early lap here.
Rossi in 14th place when they crossed, sorry, 13th place when they crossed the line, and Lorenzo in 8th.
Lorenzo's out horribly wide and turned them before. He was trying to make a move on Jack Miller. He almost dropped back behind Nicky Hayden as well, so Lorenzo just perhaps getting a little bit impatient, struggling to stop that factory MR with the full fuel tank going into that tyre hairpin at turn 4.
Not a great start by Maverick Vinales. He was in 11th place when they crossed the line.
Loris Bowes has had to retire from this Grand Prix. He's certainly entered the pits. It's been a nightmare for the Frenchman.
Up at the top of Lukey Heights they come. Marquez at the front. Paul Espargaro, Cal Crutchlow, Alex Espargaro, Petrucci.
Miller fights
Jack
back.
Miller fights back against Andrea Dovizioso. Just runs in a little bit wide of Dovizioso. Retakes that sixth place.
Yeah. To make the move, he had to just run in a fraction hotter. Andrea Dovizioso is too long, too wide. Thanks to Epp, brilliantly back up the inside. Marc Marquez has already started to stretch the field out here at the front. Marquez comes over the line to complete lap number two. A 1:33.24 for Marquez. His lead is already up to nearly 7/10 of a second.
Vinales and Rossi find it out for 10th place as they go across the line. Behind Valentino Rossi closing up on Vinales. Fastest lap, 1:33.24 for Marc Marquez. It was the start that everybody dreaded, wasn't it?
Vinales was out way, way wide in the southern loop as he tried to find a way through on Nicky Hayden. Here's the two 2017 factory Yamaha teammates, Vinales and Rossi, having a pretty good fight. Confirmation there that Loris Bowes is out of this Australian Grand Prix. Jack Miller was well wide coming through the stone corner there.
Here is Jack Miller through turn four up towards Siberia. It's Jorge Lorenzo in front of him. Through Siberia they come. Rossi has got in front of Maverick Vinales and now closes up on his own teammate at Ducati. Nicky Hayden.
Marc Marquez now leads this Australian Grand Prix on lap number three by over a second. He's checking out the front of this race, is the new world champion.
battle though between Hayden, Rossi and Vinales.
Yeah, Rossi through on Hayden then at turn number 10, so Valentino Rossi up inside the top 10 for the first time in this race. Has also got through, didn't he, on Nicky Hayden, so Nicky Hayden's getting a little bit beaten up in the early exchanges.
24 laps to go and Marc Marquez crosses the line, the advantage almost 1.5 seconds.
Yeah, Marquez has already dipped into the 129 to 129.830. Carlos Margo is coming in real pressure here from Andrea Dovizioso. Cal Crutchlow in third place on the LCR Honda. Good battle this for second place.
It is, because Alessio Spargo is right behind Cal Crutchlow, so he's sandwiched between the two brothers. The younger one, Paul, chasing his first ever podium in a MotoGP. They close up for turn four, and that's the main in station. We ride with Cal Crutchlow as they come up through Siberia. Marc Marquez is already through there. There is Andrea Dovizioso. Jorge Lorenzo.
Rossi's through on Jack Miller. So Valentino Rossi's now up into eighth place. Maverick Vinales now all over the rear tyre of Jack Miller, the Australian 21-year-old. Looks like Cal Crutchlow was making a move on Paul Espargaro through turn number eight. Couldn't quite find a way through, but Crutchlow's ever so close. Is he close enough to attack? Attack through Yamaha man down into turn number 10. Not this time around.
He's got to come back. He's on the outside. Can he get up the inside at turn 11? Place to overtake him. Alessio Spargaro on his tail now. And there's two frighteningly fast left handers that bring him on the garden straight. He's got up the inside, Crutchlow. Cal Crutchlow moved into second place. Can they slipstream him as they come down the garden straight into the two and corner? And can Alessio Spargaro get through as well? Almost three abreast as they come into two and.
Last time around, Alessio Spargaro is going to second place using the slipstream perfectly. On the last lap, Marc Marquez was a full second quicker than the rest of the field. He has long gone into the distance. Marquez leads this Australian Grand Prix by 2.5 seconds. He did a 129.8. No other rider as yet in this Grand Prix has been able to duck into the 129s. Paul Espargaro and Cal Crutchlow were a second off his pace.
Going to be a hell of a battle though for second place. Alessio Spargaro leads away in turn four. We ride with Cal Crutchlow. Paul Espargaro right in there. Danilo Petrucci having a great ride. Valentino Rossi is closing on them all the time. We see Andrea Dovizioso running at the moment in sixth place. So Rossi has now actually got past Danilo Petrucci, I think.
Get back in this battle of second place. To Major Spargo from Cal Crutchlow as they start the rise up through to Luke Heights. Dovizioso is coming right back in the podium contention here. The gap between Dovizioso in fifth and Valentino Rossi in sixth place is 1.4 seconds. Lorenzo's taken seventh back from Petrucci.
We ride with Cal Crutchlow. Audacious move on Paul Espargaro on the previous lap. Got up the inside as they came through that final corner into the garden straight. Will he try it again? Here is Valentino Rossi. Rossi running in sixth place.
Marquez over the line then to complete that number five. And again, he's in the high 129s, 129.916. Nobody able to get within 4/10 of a second. I mean, Crutchlow can't find a way through the slipstream down to the newer corner. Nothing wrong with the top speed of that factory Suzuki.
I was going to say exactly the same thing. You'd bet your house on Crutchlow going through then out of the slipstream. Didn't get through. Through the southern loop, they curve. Named, of course, well, the next corner after Casey Stone, the six times winner here. Great to see Dovizioso ride the Ducati through there. That's not quite in the same style as Casey Stone used to. On the brakes once again, Paul Espargaro closes up on Crutchlow. Crutchlow in turn closes up on Alessio Spargaro, and they remain in the same positions. And all the time, Dovizioso and particularly Valentino Rossi are closing. This is going to be a hell of a battle for second place.
Maverick Vinales just took seventh place. Jorge Lorenzo at turn number four, but the gap to Valentino Rossi is already up to almost a second. Last time around, Valentino Rossi was the second quickest rider on the track in the 130.087. That was just a tenth of a second behind Marquez. So Rossi's got podium pace, but starting from 15, he just gives himself a mountain to climb. Crutchlow up in a second.
Yeah, at the bottom of the hill, turn 10, the old MG corner. Cal Crutchlow gets up the inside of Alessio Spargaro. Can he hang in there? We will find out through these two fast left-handers that bring him onto the start and finish straight. Crutchlow has already opened up a little bit of an advantage on Alessio Spargaro. Marquez crosses the line, 21 laps to go.
advantage is almost 3 seconds. We said about Valentino Rossi being the man on the charge. Well, Rossi's just dropped into the 129s. Rossi's just on the best lap of the race, so 129.795. So Valentino Rossi is coming right back into contention for this podium position. He's now just 7/10 of a second behind Andrea Dovizioso and Pol Espargaró, and he's closing rapidly, coming out of the southern loop.
Yeah, Dovizioso has now got past Pol Espargaró, who led the way on that Tech 3 Yamaha through the Stoneham corner. Crotch lower laces by Dovizioso. Rossi now right on the rear wheel of Pol Espargaró. We ride with Valentino Rossi.
Well, Rossi was a second a lap faster last time around than Pol Espargaró. He's going to make mincemeat of those guys in front of him. Carry on with this rhythm, because Rossi is the fastest man on the track right now.
Run along the top end of the circuit through turns 8 and 9, then up over the rise, Lukey Heights, then climbs down towards the turn. Then is Rossi close enough to have a nibble at Pol Espargaró as they come down towards turn 10?
Yeah, he is. Classic turn 10.
Podium award ceremony. Let's take a look at the final MotoGP race results. This rider has been able to impose a frantic pace on today's race, and now he and his mechanics are rightly going to party. Now the top three are stepping onto the podium. These guys were great, and Marquez was simply superb today. Amazing.